In-depth football coverage from The Athletic is now just £1 per week. See the link in the description to sign up today. The players of İstanbul Başakşehir, the new champions of Turkey, emerged one by one from the tunnel of the Fatih Terim Stadium and onto a catwalk, each with their own booming entrance song. It had been a miraculous journey for the club, which had existed in its current form for only 6 years. This was Başakşehir's first ever league championship, and only the second time a team had won the Turkish Süper Lig outside of İstanbul's big three of Fenerbahçe, Beşiktaş, and Galatasaray in 26 years. This season they became the UEFA Champions League's newest debutants, playing in the same group as Manchester United, PSG, and RB Leipzig. It is the ultimate underdog story, but there is a political dimension to their story too. Başakşehir began in 1990 as İstanbul Başakşehir Belediyesi, owned by the city's municipality. In 2014, a group of seven businessmen bought the old municipality team and renamed it Başakşehir. The team also played in orange and blue, which happened to be the colours of the AKP flag, the political party of Recep Tayyip Erdogan. Although the club's CEO, Mustafa Erut, talking to The Athletic's Adam Crafton, is clear that this is a coincidence. There was a municipality mayor in 1990, not linked to AKP, which did not exist then. This mayor went to the Netherlands and liked this orange colour, and a couple of months later, they said they were founding a sports club. He said he liked the orange colour and wanted to take it for the club. So when it changed ownership in 2014, Başakşehir became a privately owned entity, which is quite an unusual construction for Turkish football, where clubs are usually membership associations run by presidents who are voted in every few years. And with a new stadium and money to spend, they made big name signings. In Abdullah Avcı, they had one of the best up-and-coming coaches in Turkey. They bought local talent well and knew when to sell. Turkey international and current Leicester City midfielder Cengiz Under, who Başakşehir picked up in Turkey's lower leagues, was sold to Roma for €13.5 million. And according to Bora İşyar, the editor of the Turkish version of The Blizzard, Başakşehir's management has done well in hiring managers who fit their plans and have built teams around players the big three wouldn't even see as fringe players in their own squad. And now, of course, they are reaping the rewards of their prudent management through success on the field. But what about the political links? Well, the current chairman and one of the seven who invested in the club, Göksel Gümüştaş, was an AKP official and is related to the president by marriage. When Erdogan disputed last year's Istanbul mayoral elections, forcing a rerun, Gümüştaş was put in temporary charge of the city until Ekrem İmamoğlu, one of Turkey's leading opposition figures, won the rerun by a landslide. Medipol, the club's biggest sponsor, was founded by Dr. Ferhatin Koca, the Erdogan family's personal physician. He was appointed Minister of Health in 2018. Erdogan himself is a fan and famously pulled on the orange jersey when a celebrity match was held to mark the opening of the stadium. He even scored a hat-trick, his second a tidy chip over the goalkeeper. President Erdogan, after all, is well known for his love and understanding of the power of the game. His official biography states that he was actively interested in football, which taught him the significance of teamwork and spirit. He played and captained the municipal transport team to a decent level. According to a former teammate quoted in a 2002 Washington Post profile of Erdogan before he transitioned from Istanbul mayor to prime minister, his teammates would call him İmam Beckenbauer, partly because of his skill and partly because of his Islamic piety. He has often told the story on the campaign trail of how as a young player, his boyhood team Fenerbahçe tried to sign him twice, but his father prevented him so that he would concentrate on his studies. Erdogan has gone about building a new Turkish society and economy in his own pious and conservative image. Football has become a part of that process too. Football fans, however, are not so easily tamed. Supporters of the big three number in their millions, and they have at times been fiercely vocal in their criticism of the government, on everything from the hated Pasolig ID card to the 2013 Gezi Park protests, where ultras and supporters of the big three came together in what was seen as the biggest civil protests of Erdogan's rule. Many suspect Erdogan aligning himself with Başakşehir may be an attempt to redress that imbalance. He has himself, on occasion, said that he was the founder of the team. In a 2019 interview with TRT, he said, "Başakşehir FC is doing very well. I founded Başakşehir when I was the mayor of Istanbul. They are doing very well. But just two things were missing: a title and supporters. A new, much more pious fan group was set up that, unlike the Big Three's ultra groups, eschewed violence and alcohol. It was called 1453, named after the year the Ottomans conquered Istanbul. "The neighbourhood resembles the fan group," said Burak Bilili, one of the 1453's founders. "We are gentle people, fair people, respectable people. We don't believe there should be swearing or violence in the stands. We never swear and we never commit violence." But it was a tough job. Attendances at the Fatih Terim Stadium could fall to just 2,000 a game, something which Erdogan noticed when he visited the Başakşehir district's local AKP branch. But the sparse crowds might not have been a bad thing after all. After stumbling during the final weeks of the season, Başakşehir finally won the title in a COVID-19 hit 2019-20 campaign played behind closed doors. As the Swiss international Gökhan İnler told the BBC World Service's World Football Show, they'd got used to playing without fans. "The last 3-4 months, the big clubs did not have any supporters. We play between 4,000 and 10,000 at home and away games, so not many. We are used to playing like this for many years. We played against Trabzonspor, but there were no supporters. Usually in Trabzonspor, the stadium will be full, and then we feel the pressure. But now, without fans, we draw the game." And so the title was won, and the players were honoured. The entire squad was also invited for a rare meeting at the Presidential Palace in Ankara. For the club CEO, Mustafa Erut, talk of a link between the club and the state in the wake of their historic triumph are sour grapes. Talking to The Athletic, he said, "There is no organic relationship between the club and the president. There are some people close to him and some not close to him. We have some government sponsors and some private sector sponsors, just like all other clubs in Turkey. Okay, our stadium was made by the government, but there are 25 other stadiums made by the government and long-term rented to the clubs, including big-name clubs. I cannot agree with these protests." Başakşehir has had a mixed start to the season, but fans aren't likely to return until next year at the earliest, and even then, there's a chance the stadiums might not return to that same intensity for years, if ever. Maybe it's already Başakşehir's world, and we are just living in it. Tifo is delighted to be able to offer full access to The Athletic now for just £1 per week. Read in-depth coverage of your favourite teams across 10 different sports, provided by some of the best sports journalists in the world. Follow the stories that you care about with closer access and intelligent takes. Whether it's sports news, tactics, or finances, you'll find it all on The Athletic, alongside a host of brilliant podcasts dedicated to different teams. So, see the link in the description now. Thanks for supporting Tifo and, of course, watching today's video.